Hello everyone, welcome once again to this online physics class. So we are doing this chapter, that is chapter number 10, gravitation. So we have started solving the sums which are given at the end of the lesson under that exercise portion along with few questions. So already I have solved 5 sums and I have not numbered as per your textbook. I have just numbered as per the sums I am doing. Like totally in all I have solved 5 sums. Today I have taken up the 6th sum. Okay, so today I have taken up only one sum because it's quite lengthy and I want you all to pay proper attention to what is taught and please practice after the teaching session is over. Okay, now let's see how the sum is. See, question number 6, because I said I have solved already 5 questions. A stone is allowed to fall from the top of a tower 100 meter high and at the same time another stone is projected vertically upwards from the ground with a velocity of 25 meter per second. Calculate when and where the stones will meet. See here, the question is given as a stone is allowed to fall from the top of a tower and the height of the tower is 100 meters. Okay, at the same time another stone is projected, means thrown vertically upwards from the ground with a velocity of 25 meter per second. You have to calculate when and where the stones will meet. Okay, see here, the height of the tower is given as 100 meters. Let's assume here 100 meters. Okay, a stone is dropped from the top of the tower, a stone here. At the same time another stone is thrown vertically upwards. Both the stones will meet at one place. So they want you to calculate when and where the stones will meet. See, height of the tower is given as 100 meters. Suppose we assume the point at which the two stones meet each other as P. And the height of the point P from the ground will be assumed as X meters, because the height of the tower is already given in the question as 100 meters. And one stone is dropped from the top of the tower and another stone is thrown vertically upwards. Both the stones are meeting at a point P. So the distance of this point P from the ground will be X. It's our assumption. Therefore, the distance of point P from the top of the tower will be what? 100 minus X, because the total distance is 100. Suppose P is located at a point X, means the distance of point P from the top of the tower will be 100 minus X meters. Clear to you? Again, I'll explain you. See, there is a tower. Its height is 100 meters. Okay, height of the tower is 100 meters. One stone is dropped from the top of the tower. Okay, another stone is thrown vertically upwards. They have told you to calculate when and where the stones will meet each other. Let's assume the point at which both the stones meet each other as point P. So we know the height of the tower, it is 100 meters. So what will be the distance of point P from the ground? We'll assume it as X meters. 100 meter is the height of the tower and X meter is the distance between point P and the ground, the total distance. Now what will be the distance between point P and the point, means at the end of the tower? So distance between the top of the tower till point P will be what? 100 minus X. Why 100 minus X? Because total distance, height of the tower is 100 meters. Point P is located at a distance X meters from the ground. Therefore, from the top to point P, the distance will be what? This X, total height is 100. So this X will go there, no? So means it should be subtracted. So 100 minus X. Clear to you? Okay. Now, see, first, for the stone falling from the top of the tower, we have to calculate the height, right? Height is assumed as 100 minus X meters. That X we want. What is X? It is a distance between the ground and point P. Initial velocity u is 0 meter per second. Time is also not given there. okay. Acceleration due to gravity on the ground is always 9.8 meter per second square. Now we'll use the second equation of motion. S is equal to ut plus half at square. Since we are talking about the stone which is thrown vertically upwards, a stone falling towards the ground, instead of a we'll be using g, because we are talking about acceleration due to gravity here. So we'll rewrite the equation, that is s is equal to ut plus half at square should be rewritten as s is equal to ut plus half gt square. Okay, now in this u is 0, right? So h is equal to ut plus half gt square. Okay, h, we are talking about the stone which is falling from the top of the tower. So what is the height? As I told you, distance between the top of the tower till point P will be 100 minus x. That I'll substitute here. 100 minus x is equal to u is what? 0. T we don't know, right? Plus half. G value is 9.8. T we don't know. So we'll assume it as t square only. This 2 and 9.8, when we cancel, we get it as 4.9, right? So now 0 into t is 0 only. So we will write the equation now as 100 minus x is equal to 0 plus 4.9 t square. That is 100 minus x is equal to 4.9 t square. Okay, this equation. We'll consider this as equation number 1. Okay. This is for the stone which is falling from the top of the tower. We need to calculate the value of x. X is what? It is the distance between the place where the two stones meet each other, that is point P, from the ground. We have assumed that as x meters. So from the top of the tower to point P will be 100 minus x, because the height of the tower is given as 100 meters. So when we are talking about the stone that is falling from the top of the tower, we will take up this equation of motion, that is second equation, and I told you how to substitute the values, and this equation we got, and we will assume this as equation number 1. Now let's move to the next part. Now let's talk about the stone which is projected upwards, that is which is thrown vertically upwards from the ground. Height till the place where this two stones meet each other is considered as point P. So we assume that distance as x meters. Velocity is given in the question itself as 25 meter per second. Time is not given. So again, in this equation, when we substitute that is s is equal to ut plus half gt square, this s should be h, no? So h is what? X. Your u is 25 into t. Again here g will be 9.8, right? Plus half into 9.8 into t square. So when you cancel this 2 and 9.8, you get 4.9. so you can rewrite the equation as x is equal to 25 t minus 4.9 t square. Here we'll assume the value of g as minus 9.8. why? Because it is working against the force of gravity. Whenever the object is thrown upwards, it is negative value, right? So we are taking the value of g as minus 9.8 meter per second square. So when we substitute those values, we get x as 25t minus 4.9 t square. We'll consider this as equation number 2. Again, I'm telling, when we are talking about the height, when the stone is thrown vertically upwards, we have assumed the distance between point P, that is the point where two stones meet each other, from the ground, we have assumed as x meters. So when you substitute that value of x in that place of s, that means your h, and u, it's given in the question itself as 25. T is not known to us. So 25 into T will give you 25T plus half GT square. G value will be taken as minus 9.8, because here we are talking about a stone which is moving upwards. Whenever the object is going upwards, the acceleration due to gravity value will become negative. That is half into minus 9.8 t square. When you cancel this 2 and 9.8, you get 4.9. There is a negative sign there. So you write the equation as 25t minus 4.9 t square. Clear to you? This is equation number 2. Okay, now we have to add both the equations. On adding equations 1 and 2. So let me write the equation for you. First equation is 100 minus x is equal to 4.9 t square. And your second equation is x is equal to 25t minus 4.9 t square. Right? Now, when we add, how will we add now? See, these are the two equations. How will we add? 100 minus x plus x is equal to 4.9 t square plus 25 t minus 4.9 t square, right? So t square. So here one 4.9 t square and here negative minus 4.9 t square. So both the things gets cancelled. And here minus x and plus x. I'll show once again here. See, in the here you see on the screen, 100 minus x plus x is equal to 4.9 t square plus 25 t minus 4.9 t square. So plus x and minus x gets cancelled. Similarly, 4.9 t square and minus 4.9 t square gets cancelled. So you get 100 is equal to 25 t. And what will be the value of t now? When 100 is equal to 25 t, your t will be 100 divided by 25, which is equal to 4 seconds. Now you have to substitute the value of this time t in your first equation. So in your first equation, what is the first equation? You all remember, 100 minus x is equal to 4.9 t square. In this place, when I substitute the value of t, I get it as 100 minus x is equal to 4.9 into 4 seconds the whole square, right? So 4 the whole square is 16. So it is 16 seconds square. Now, what is the answer you are getting now? 100 minus x is equal to 4.9 into 16 seconds square, right? This is your equation that you are getting after substituting the value of t. So now, when you are multiplying, see, 4.9 into 16, you get the value 78.4. So now when we write the equation as 100 minus x is equal to 78.4, because there, you remember here, 4.9 into 100 minus x is equal to 4.9 into 16 x square. If you will write that and keep here, see here, 100 minus x is equal to 4.9 into 16 second square, right? So 4.9 into 16 will give you 78.4. So 100 minus x is equal to 78.4. Okay. Now I want x. I want the value of x. So x will be what? X is equal to this 78.4. When it, see, x is going that side and 78.4 is coming this side. So it becomes minus 100 minus 78.4, which is equal to 21.6 meters. Therefore, the value of x is 21.6 meter. So the two stones will meet at a height of 21.6 meters from the ground. You remember, we have already said that the two stones are meeting at a point P, one that is coming from the top of the tower and then the other one which is thrown from the ground. They both are meeting at the point P, okay? And the distance of point P from the ground will be assumed as x, right? So that x value is the point P is also there, right? It is the distance between point P and the ground is assumed as x meters. So that x value is got as 21.6 meters. So distance between point P and the ground is 21.6 meters, means the two stones will meet at a height of 21.6 meter from the ground. So with this we are coming to an end of today's session. Please practice this sum. It's very simple. Okay, in the question they have given you a velocity that is given after the sentence of the stone which is thrown vertically upwards. So the velocity should be assumed for that stone which is going upwards, right? For the first case, when it is thrown from the top of the tower, the velocity will be 0 meter per second. Okay, play the video once again, listen to it carefully, practice. Okay, meet you soon in the next class. Till then, take care and bye.